What's up, everyone? Take a look at this.
And Cyrus, we're in bed together.
Hold on.
I'm usually not this quick to get in bed with someone, but you made me come here. Some people wrangled me into this room. This is really wrong,
what just happened. Hold on, girl. Hold on.
You had a bunch of people wrangle me and bring me to a room with just you in a bed.
So, Miley, how you doing?
I'm doing, and cameras. Yeah. This is all so crazy. This is really, you guys are
Brooklyn Bedding.
Thank
Welcome to KT4A.
Thank you very much.
You're looking good.
Thank you very much.
First of
so
all,
are
you're,
you.
You're, thank you? Really?
You got on my favorite color.
Okay. All right. You're well, way too dressed for me.
What do you mean?
Really? I didn't shave my legs. All right.
So that's pretty rough.
I was expecting like a unicorn onesie or something like
this
that.
This is my new vibe. Feels very weird when like your main thing you preach is be yourself and then you feel like you're not being yourself anymore.
Right,
so
right.
This is as bland as I can be and just kind of be more my own self than to hide as a unicorn.
This is the first time we're seeing the hair like this.
This is my hair.
I'm talking about the color.
You just grow it out, and it just magically becomes this weird line.
All right. Okay. Yeah. All right. Okay. What can we expect tonight? We are backstage with Miley Cyrus. Talk to me about tonight.
I'm excited. I get to perform Malibu. I was just saying I was doing a meet and greet, and we were just talking about how I've performed Malibu everywhere around the country.
Right.
Got to play it around the world.
Right.
But I never find myself in Malibu these days
right.
because I'm always getting to play these shows. And I just was home in Nashville for a little while. So I like singing this song right now because I'm not home very much.
And it's down tempo, though. It's a down tempo. Well, how are you going to approach people on a massive stage?
I think people have fun with it. I think, too.
Is it just a guitar?
No, I got a fiddle. I got a pedal steel. So I'm trying to, I'm from Nashville. I live in Malibu, but I'm from Nashville. So I'm trying to bring that. Here to
no hoe down, throw down.
I don't know if you'll get up on stage and do it. I'm down.
I'm trying to get it down. The hoe down, throw.
I can't remember. You're gonna have to ask my guitar player.
Most of your choreography is all upper body.
Yeah,
it's all.
I have no footwork and no balance.
It's all.
Yeah, I have a mean robot, and then I can go like this.
Exactly.
And that's pretty much it.
What can we expect? Of course, we're heard all over the country right now. What can we expect on the new tour coming up? Are you leaving? Was Bangers a phase?
No, Bangers, today's the 4-year anniversary of Can't Stop. I'm really excited about Bangers. I think everything I do isn't really a phase. It's just that, you know, I may be
the
a
tongue.
Time in your
I'm
life.
I'm talking about the tongue.
I still have a tongue. Isn't that crazy? I still
have a tongue. When you roll down the tongue and...
That now goes into my pool.
Oh, it does?
It. No,
okay.
But all I tried to make it happen, but it didn't work.
All right. Like the riding the hot dog?
I wish. You know, I don't wear the same outfit twice, so I never use the same hot dog twice.
Right.
Is that my point?
What I was most impressed was is the balloons.
Oh, we've got a lot of those.
I mean,
we got
that's
a lot
massive.
Of those. We bought a lot of those. I try to bring the balloons wherever I go.
Right.
I think they represent kind of where I am. They're very like colorful and they feel very free. And
who's the intern that blows up 5 million balloons?
We got a lot of people back there. We got big tanks. So
right.
We roll deep.
How many balloons?
Tonight we probably have a couple thousand balloons.
Oh, here?
Out there. Always, yeah.
No,
out
but
there.
On your regular tour, it's thousands.
Thousands of balloons. We got thousands. I bring thousands wherever I go.
Okay.
Even if it's like just to like the grocery store.
All right. Let's talk about The Voice really quickly.
Yeah.
You're bringing your dad on this season.
My dad's going to be my mentor. Last year, I brought Joan Jett.
Right.
And I realized that I had to bring out kind of like my special force because I want to get more country singers on my team so I can finally compete
with Blake Shelton. Yeah.
So I brought out my dad, which I think he's going to be awesome. And he's been the best mentor for me. He's made me always really, you know, listen to music and make the best music I can. And he has always really interesting song choices, which I'd like him to help me pick the right songs for my team as well. So I feel like I have a really big kind of advantage, I think.
And he could stand in for you if there's any arguments with Adam.
Yes, it's going to be perfect.
Is Adam still a pain in the ass to you?
Adam's actually pretty great. I think him and I
But there were rumors that there was...
There's rumors about everything. I'm like pregnant or dead every day, so I don't believe anything I read about myself.
Right.
I actually really like Adam a lot.
All right, so quickly, you are opening up. A lot of people don't realize that she's actually the opening act, I think.
Which is
everybody would think that it's Miley Cyrus. She would actually be closing it, but you are actually going to the Manchester benefit
concert.
Yeah,
One Love a Benefit. I'm really excited, and you know, my friend Ariana, I asked her one time to do something for Happy Hippie, and she did it without even a blink of an eye. So I feel like I kind of definitely would like to do the same thing for her. And I think a great thing about Ariana and I too, I think she's someone that with her music and the way that she's really responding and the way that she's reacting
Amazing.
To what happened, I think she's really showing herself as a person with a lot of respect and integrity and a really great honorable person. So I think now this is just going to make me more excited to see what she's going to do next in her life and in her music, because music is from experience, and she's experienced something that a lot of us can't relate to. So I'd like to see how she interprets that in her new songs.
Have you talked to her?
Just a little bit, just about, we're going to do Don't Dream It's Over at the show.
How, so it really must like be it. Such a heavy load to everybody came out to see you, and then something as tragic as that happened.
Yeah, I think the great thing is that everyone had a lot of fun at the show, it seems, you know, until something horrific happens. And I think people come there because they love her a lot. And I think the way that she's reacting shows who she is as a person more than someone that's just a great voice. And I think, who cares if you have a great voice? You want to be a great person.
Yeah, of course, of course. It's going to be a great show. You got to actually get on a plane right. You're going to get off stage. Jump on a plane at JFK and
put on my pajamas and go.
Fly to England. Okay, last question. I want to pimp really quickly. Malibu.
Yes.
From Malibu.
Yes. It looks like we're kind of. I like. This is my first time that I've.
Now the water's
a
little dirty for Malibu.
That's okay.
You know what I mean?
I think I.
That's really not.
That's my brother out there surfing. No.
You wrote it in the car.
I wrote it in the car. I write a lot of things in the car because I'm not sitting still very often. I'm kind of a hyper person, so
right.
I don't sit still very often. So I'm in the car. That's kind of when I get the most creative. But I think I'm gonna have a really special show tonight because I never get to perform this song on the water before.
All right.
And I think that's gonna bring some inspiration.
Exactly. Right here at Jones Beach. Last question, Killer Angel Baby.
Yes.
How's that frog
You've
doing?
Done your research.
No, Killer Angel
Baby.
Killer
Angel Baby, he's like a superstar now.
If you don't know what we're talking about, she actually has a frog in her backyard that you're the frog is going to be part of the album?
Yes, he's got a feature. He's my one and only feature on the record so far.
Right.
We put a recorder out one night and just recorded Killer Angel Baby.
Which is a frog, a real frog.
Yes, he's on the first track of my record, and he's actually on the last track of my record.
Right.
But I'm waiting for the day that one of these big labels signs Killer Angel Baby, and now I'm going to have to give him 10% of every song I have him on.
All right.
I hope he never gets a good lawyer.
Okay, I want you to do me a favor. I want you to look into that camera.
Hello.
And I want you to say anything you want.
You don't want that.
Anything you want. Anything you want.
I promise you don't want that.
All right, go ahead. Just let it loose, girl.
All right, everyone. I just want to thank you so much. For anyone that showed up to the show today, that's amazing. Anyone that has got to listen to Malibu, anyone that's enjoyed it, even if you don't enjoy it, I'm glad you at least listened to it enough to know you don't like it. And always be a good person. I think that's something I should tell people. Always be a good person.
All right, right here. Miley Cyrus, right here.
Thank you so much.
KT Euphoria.